course, Amy, who is Laney's human. Amy, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks, guys, so much for having us. We're really excited.
Obviously, look at that, just wanting attention. Laney is from the Paws for Patients program, working with the Osborne Head and Neck Foundation. And Amy, the foundation is a medical nonprofit. Can you tell us a little bit about what you guys do?
Yes, so the Osborne Head and Neck Foundation, we provide pro bono ear, nose, and throat surgeries for people domestically and all around the world.
Wow. And what does Laney do for these families?
Not the surgery, I'm assuming.
So originally, our goal, our plan before COVID-19 was to provide inpatient visits, but due to COVID-19, we had to kind of stop our inpatient visits and kind of adapt. So we didn't want to stop our program. So we decided to adapt since everybody's going virtual now. And we thought, what better way to offer community service by offering our therapy program online?
Oh my God.
It's so cute. Oh, and you've noticed.
It's so bad.
I know. It reminds me of cannoli just constantly needing attention. You've noticed that patients have a decreased perception of pain and less anxiety. This seems common sense because we already get that when we play with our dogs, but I only imagine it's heightened in a medical setting.
Oh, definitely. Like, I mean, since the beginning of time, people have relied on animals for various things, for whether it's the safety back in like primitive days, you know, when the animals worried or concerned, humans realized, oh, then I should be worried. There might be something that's going to eat me out there. And then it just kind of progressed over time when animals became more domesticated. And we've found that animals have a healing benefit to our patients and people, especially with people who are recovering from surgery. It helps distract them from pain. A lot of patients and people don't want to do anything, but when you add a dog in there, they feel a little bit extra incentive to do something. And it just, overall, it brings a smile to everyone's face to be able to see, you know, an animal that's, you know, just gonna love you unconditionally, not judge you.
Well, and so you're connecting with these patients over Zoom though, right? I mean, it's not, you can't do it physically, so you're doing it online.
Yes, which is honestly remarkable. Like, we didn't realize the outpour of support on the program, but we realized that there were so many people that were just looking for an opportunity to connect with somebody. And then couple that with Laney, we've noticed that it brought a lot of smiles to people. It's helped a lot of people that have been kind of feeling, you know, a little bit in the funk because they've been home, you know, due to COVID-19.
Well, I want to ask too, because when Sam first sent me the story and she sent me some of the images of the Zoom calls, it made me want to cry because it was so adorable. It was so sweet. What are some specific stories maybe of things that have people you've connected with over this period?
One particular patient that, one person that stuck out to me. Come on, Laney, sorry, baby. Come on, stay. Stay right there, stay. One particular patient that stuck out to me was a woman. She just recently had a really invasive surgery, and she obviously could not go out during this whole period. She's actually at risk, and so she's been really kind of depressed because of her inability to go out. And so we reached out to her, and it just kind of completely brightened her day and just made her feel so happy just to have that moment of interaction with somebody. And then there was a couple kids that Laney was able to kind of be there for, and they were able to read to her.
When Cinderella finished to all the tricks or cheaters.
And his legacy, Miyamoto Musashi, is known as Japan as a kensei.
And it was just a really nice, heartwarming moment for me. And then I think my most favorite one was Mother's Day. Come on, Laney, come here, up here, come here, baby. She's a little hyper, it's lunchtime.
It is.
We had like a mini family reunion before Mother's Day, and the little boy that owns Laney's mom read to her, and then the mom popped in the video. And they were actually kind of talking to each other. So that was like so cute. And my heart just kind of like, oh my God, this is so
wow.
So Robert has a book behind him called Love Me Gently about how to pet a dog. And I imagine kids, you get everything from a scared, timid child to a kid who just wants to go grab the dog and shake it and pull its tail. I imagine Laney has to be good with all those situations as a therapy dog.
Oh yeah, definitely. And as a handler for a therapy dog, you want to be your pet's best advocate. So if someone is like kind of petting them too rough, you kind of want to gently let them know, well, Laney doesn't like to be pet that way, but if you do it this way, she'll like it even better.
So what is the proper way to pet a dog you've just met?
What I would do, especially because you don't know if the dog is, you know, tame or not, is like I would ask the owner if it's okay if you pet your dog. And for Laney, since she is a canine good citizen, it's important that she sits before you come pet her, because I don't want her jumping on you. It just propagates manners.
Well, she's very well behaved, but she also has quite a wardrobe. I saw some photos. The kids have got to get a kick out of those, seeing a pup dressed up.
Oh yeah, it's just something that I like to do for fun with Laney, because I know people love just seeing, you know, cute animals, and it's just something to brighten people's day. You know, it's nothing serious. It's just something fun. You know.
Yeah. Well, I love that, you know, and I hope we can share some of the photos here. And I know that you sent some video that we're going to look at some point. But the look on the kids' faces when they see the dog, I think that, you know, obviously you can't go out and meet dogs in the world anymore. And that might be one of the saddest things among all the other sad things that are happening here, is just our connection with each other, especially for people who emotionally rely on these kinds of animals. So I think it's really wonderful that you're able to do this and connect with people.
I mean, the look on our faces when we saw Laney pop up in the chat, that's enough to...
You know, in a way, right, it also right just, it makes me even, like, I just want that dog now. I just want to go, I want to hang out with Laney.
Robert, how would you pet Laney?
Oh, I'd rub my face next to hers and have her give me kisses all over.
Oh my God.
What I was wondering, there's a difference between tame dogs and, like, obviously untamed, but with Laney in particular, how many hours she's been through of training so she could be able to be around these people and behave the way she does?
Oh my God, the second day I got her, it was when I started beginning her, like, training to become a therapy dog. So the moment she was able to get her shots, we began, like, obedience training at Petco for 12 weeks, and then every weekend I was taking her to puppy playtime Saturday and Sunday, and then constantly taking her out, interacting with people, just letting her know not to be afraid of people. So it's a lot of work in those just like first moments of when you take a puppy home, because those are the times where they can feel fear and stuff like that. So you kind of want to get them accustomed to all sorts of people from all walks of life, all sorts of objects, just so that they're not going to be afraid of that later.
And simultaneously, are you also socializing them with other pets as well? Are they as trained as they are with people as they are with other pets?
Well, they're not therapy dogs for other dogs.
Well,
I actually have another dog. He's an older dachshund, and they've been kind of interacting since like I've had Laney, and I'm always interacting her with my neighbor's dogs and as many animals I can find. And actually, you know, since we've been doing that, whenever we see another dog kind of walking by, instead of barking, she just sits down and kind of just properly waits for acknowledgement from the other dog.
So cute. So regal.
Yeah,
so I do want to know, because so many people are going to watch this and think, can I just do this? Can I just Zoom with this dog? Is this free? Where do we go? I know you can schedule an online session through ohnifoundation.com/pause, but is it FaceTime? Is it Zoom like we're doing now? Where can we go to schedule a therapy session?
So definitely you can make an appointment using that website, ohnifoundation.com/pause. And we are open doing this on Zoom, FaceTime, and then I believe Skype, you know, whatever you have. We even had somebody that didn't have the ability to use any of that, so we did Facebook Messenger.
Oh,
very tech savvy over here.
Yeah. And Laney's on Instagram too, right?
She is on Instagram and on TikTok.
So where do we go to find Laney on social?
So Laney is Golden Laney, So that's Laney, L-A-N-E-Y. That's for her Instagram. And then for her TikTok, it's GoldenLaney1. Then you can see a bunch of cute videos of her dressing and stuff. Little silly music videos and stuff.
So cute.
She's so adorable and sweet. And like the perfect golden retriever. Like if you looked up golden retriever in an encyclopedia, it would be her little face.
Yeah, I got really lucky with her because there was quite a few other goldens that I had the choice of, but she was like the most calm and the most loving out of all the puppies. As soon as I picked her up, she literally fell asleep in my arms. Like I held her up and down, and I was like, "Oh my god, you were totally the one."
Oh my god, I just want to pet those little eyebrows.
Come on, let me sit. Go look at the camera.
Right.
Oh my gosh, we look like such weirdos. Thank you so much for spending time with us today.
Yes.
Laney, does Laney want to do any tricks for us before we go?
Laney.
Yeah, I can get her to do some tricks. Let's see. Laney, speak. Louder, speak.
She's like, Laney. I'm on the news. I can't,
speak.
Mom.
Speak. Come on, speak.
Oh, that was good. That was good.
Laney, sit. Lenny, sit.
There, I should speak. You should have told her to sit.
High five me.
Yeah.
Girl.
Oh, he's so sweet.
Turn. Oh, can you, here, sit up here. Down. Good girl. Lenny, bang. Good girl.
Oh my gosh, so cute. Oh, those little ears. Laney and Amy, thank you guys so much for joining us today on 5 Live. A good boy indeed, in this case, good girl. But please, if you guys are so interested, check out the Osborne Head and Neck Foundation on their website. You can find how to make an appointment with Laney. Amy, thank you.